The topic of software architecture, similar to the topic of testing, is full of confusion, bias, and misunderstanding. Part of the reason for this complexity is that there are many different topics to get into. Another reason is because many teachers do not understand software architecture much beyond just parroting what other teachers say about it. In my case, most of my knowledge of software architecture has come from thousands of hours spent building programs. As such, I am able to explain things in a unique way without leaning on too much jargon. We will not cover every topic in the field, but there is one principle in particular which I have come to understand as being the most important principle in software architecture. In the following lessons, I am going to show you this principle and how to apply it to everything from individual methods up to entire projects. But first, I want to give you the simplest analogy I could think of to explain separation of concerns. The following is a true story. One day, I was walking to work, and I saw that a sidewalk, or footpath as they say outside of North America, had been replaced. The old sidewalk looked something like you see here, and I was happy to see it replaced because I kept scuffing my shoes on the uneven surface, and back then it was part of my job to have well-kept clothing. The new sidewalk looked like this. Instead of a single continuous layer, it was separated into different pieces. Being an obsessive overanalyzer, I asked myself the question, why build sidewalks in different pieces like that? I did not know it at the time, but the answers to that question captured the essence of why one applies separation of concerns in any interconnected system, from software systems to hardware systems to businesses to sidewalks. A modular system, that is a system which applies separation of concerns, provides these benefits. If one part breaks, it is easier to find the fault and to fix it. It is easier to build each part in isolation of the other parts. It is easier to test each part in isolation of the other parts. It is easier to name each part. There are other benefits, but that should suffice for now. Let us contrast this with a continuous, or as we say in software development, monolithic system. If one part breaks, the integrity of the entire system often breaks. Because of that, it can be difficult to isolate the origin of the fault. In most cases, you must build the whole system or most of the system before you can test at all. It is difficult to give a good descriptive name for something which does everything. It is often highly difficult to read and understand the system, even for the people who built it. I could go on, but the point should be obvious by now. Before we finish this lesson, I wanted to address something for those of you who are not necessarily absolute beginners. If you really are an absolute beginner, do not worry too much about what I'm going to say next. I will explain it in detail later. The most common question I am asked during my livestream Q&A videos takes the form of, Ryan, what is the best software architecture? Or, is Model View View Model better than Model View Presenter? What about Model View Controller? I thought I would answer that for any of my students who want to know and might feel disappointed that I will not be going into the specifics of any particular front-end GUI architecture. The answer I always give is that the best architecture depends entirely on the feature of the application you are trying to build. In other words, there is no such thing as the best architecture for every situation. In fact, I will use whatever combination of these styles I feel is most appropriate. So do not worry, in subsequent lessons, I will teach you the principles common to all of these architectures.